decades ago, and this is another one recorded at the now defunct American studios somewhere in the 818 area. So cast your mind back. Those of you who are old enough to remember them, the days of car phones. In order to have a mobile phone, you had to have a car. I know y'all are born on four wheels here, and therefore, if you're going to even have a life, you have a car. But it's different for us in Britain. There were only three automobiles in the whole country until the Beatles came along. And then there were four of them. So John, Paul, and George all bought cars, and Ringo had to have one specially made. Even the royal family began to take notice. My God, what's going on there, Elizabeth?
I can't really tell.
You've got your binoculars the wrong way round, Your Highness.
Shut up! I can see perfectly well from here. Oh, it's those hairy boys in an automobile.
So the royal family had a whole load of cars built, and then pretty soon even my parents had cars, but they didn't know how to drive them. So we had a car parked in front of our house, and none of us could get in to it. We'd seen pictures of the Beatles in their cars, and we knew that Paul McCartney had a car phone, but we didn't know how to get into the car. But in the end, this was a real, what y'all call a value, because we didn't spend any money on petrol, gasoline, you know. There were no costs in having this vehicle, it just sat there. Once a year, a man came around and charged us 30 shillings for having it, and my father would raid our pocket money, and he'd go out and pay, and there it was. And eventually, all my ancestors died, and the car was passed to me, which is what Prince Charles is still hoping will happen to him. Born to lose, baby. But I guess he's an inverted Scorpio. What do you know? Anyway, I don't drive, but somebody did. I know, yeah, that's right. I recorded this song. It was recorded in the days of car phones out in the valley. And the producer rang the record company and said, "Wow, listen to this." And he put the car phone in front of the cassette machine. And the cassette machine looked at the producer like, "Do I have to?" And the producer said, "Yeah, you have to." So he played it, and the record company guy said, "It's fantastic, it's a smash, I'm selling the record company." So you think you're in love?
You know it. Are you sure that this is